I know I already made a whole video about it, but damn, Billy Loomis, you are a god amongst men. Ain't nobody can dethrone Michael, but you sure give him a run for his money. Anyways, on to the video. What's up, losers? Welcome back to Zero Loser Studio. I'm Etho, and I'm going to be your host for the week, and I'm bringing back all things horror. It's no secret that I'm a huge fan of the genre, especially when we have so many videos on the channel already about it. I myself got my love of horror from my mom. Watching horror movies together is probably our number one favorite thing to do together. Mom, if you're watching this, I love you, but can you please click away because I thirst over fictional men and monsters on this channel way too much. One of our all-time favorite movies, though? Wes Craven's Scream. The movie came out in 1996 and is responsible for reviving the slasher subgenre. It became an instant classic and to this day is one of the most important horror movies in film. It's a smart yet funny story that follows our protagonist, Sydney Prescott, played by Neve Campbell, another beautiful human being. She's a high schooler in the formerly quiet town of Woodsboro, California. A year after the mysterious sexual assault and murder of her mother, an unknown killer begins to torment the students of Sydney's high school, mainly her friends. The movie's an homage to the genre and satirical while still remaining to be a great whodunit that keeps you on the edge of your seat, with the occasional laugh here and there. Again, this is one of my all-time favorite movies, but this video's not about Scream. Well, not really. This video is about Danny Rowling, or most commonly known as the Gainesville Ripper. Now, before we begin, I do want to give a small disclaimer that this video is going to be a little bit heavier than most of the ones that came before it. This is a real life case that involves sensitive topics such as murder, assault, and abuse. Please see us next week if this is too much for you. For those of you still here though, let's get on with the case. Danny Rowling was born in 1954 in Shreveport, Louisiana. He was the son of a 19-year-old mother and a Korean War vet. Growing up, as is the case with most serial killers, Danny had a difficult life faced with verbal and physical abuse from his father. He joined the Air Force later in life, but was kicked out in 1973 due to charges of drug possession. He then lived with his grandfather for a short period of time where he met his future wife, Omather Halko, probably pronouncing that wrong by the way. However, as is also often the case, Danny ended up casting the same abuse onto his wife that he experienced as a kid. It later led to the separation of the two. After the separation, Rowling went on a string of armed robberies and even went as far as assaulting a woman. He was arrested in Jackson, Georgia in 1979 and multiple times throughout the 80s in Mississippi and Alabama for more of the same crimes. In 89, Rowling killed three people: 24-year-old Julie Grissom, her 8-year-old nephew, and her 55-year-old father. He then shot his own father the following year before fleeing and eventually ending up in Gainesville, Florida. He set up camp near the University of Florida where he started his infamous killing spree on August 24th of 1990. Over the course of just the next 3 days, Danny Rowling succeeded in torturing and killing 4 University of Florida students and 1 Santa Fe University student. The bodies were all found in poses purposefully put there for shock value. One of the victims, Crystal Hoyt, was found with her body decapitated. Her head was placed neatly on a bookshelf for the police to find. It was clear that the killer was making a show of his kills. The now retired Chief Assistant State Attorney Gene Singer recalls, "I like to think that there isn't evil, but that case, that was like nothing I have ever been involved with. I still can call up at a moment's notice in my brain the photographs. They're just so vile, so evil." Ugh. The college town of Gainesville was put in a state of panic as students either refused to leave their homes or just straight up moved out of town. The police desperately set out to work on finding the mysterious killer before there were any more victims, but Rowling had already skipped town. It wasn't until almost 2 years later that the police finally found their guy. Danny Rowling had already been in jail, arrested during a failed getaway after robbing a Winn-Dixie supermarket. Using DNA evidence that they got from his tooth, they were able to link Danny to the kills in Gainesville, Florida. But at this point, the murderer was already facing multiple lifetime sentences. It was determined by experts that Rowling had been suffering from a form of dissociative identity disorder, a coping mechanism built from the childhood trauma. His alter personality, a man named Gemini, was the personality that would take over Rowling whenever he committed his heinous crimes. However, psychiatrists also believe that Rowling was fully aware of the severity of his actions. On October 25th of 2006, Danny's life was put to an end at Florida State Prison. His final words were a religious hymn, including the statement, "None greater than thee, O Lord, none greater than thee." And there it is. The story of the Gainesville Ripper, or at least the slightly shortened version. As I looked more into Danny Rowling and this case, it was really easy to see how he was able to inspire some of Scream. After all, Ghostface is oftentimes overlooked because of more monstrous villains like Jason Voorhees or Freddy Krueger, both of which I do love, by the way, but come on. Ghostface is no one to laugh at. Just look at one of my personal favorite kills from any horror movie. Anyways, I'm gonna end the video here. Honestly, I love doing these true crime cases for you guys, and I'm sure I could find a bunch more that tie into more of the movies that I freaking love so much. Let me know if any of you are interested in that. And write down in the comments how you feel about the Scream movies. Love them? Hate them? Don't care about them? Haven't seen them? Please tell me you've seen them. If any of you guys say that you haven't seen any of the Scream movies, I will be very upset, but still write it down in the comments. Also, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. We post every single Friday of every single week at 4 p.m. Eastern. If you want to make sure that you don't miss any of the content, make sure you ring that notification bell. For now, you already know. Until next time, I'll see you later, losers.